Now let's look at some of the important MCQs on factoring and forfeiting. Factoring service means collection of bills, discounting of bills, maintenance of account books, or all of the above. The answer is D, that is, factoring includes collection of bills, discounting of bills, and maintenance of account books. The type of arrangements under which banks pay the seller the value of bill and later collects it from the buyer on the due date is called A. Bill discounting, B. Factoring, C. Forfeiting, D. None. Answer is A, that is, this is known as bill discounting. Next question, the type of factoring under which the factor collects back from the seller the amount paid by him in case of non-payment of the bills on the due date is called recourse factoring, non-recourse factoring, bills discounting, bills purchase. It is known as recourse factoring. Under domestic factoring, the payment of the bills that the seller gets from the factor is A. 100% of the value of the bills immediately on submission, nearly 80% of the bills amount upon tendering bill and the balance on due date, nearly 80% of the bill amount upon tendering the bill and the balance on due date after collecting from the buyer, and option D, 100% of the value of the bill only after collection from the buyer. The answer is C, that is nearly 80% of the bill amount upon tendering the bill and the balance on due date after collecting from the buyer. Question next, in international factoring, the number of factors will be 2, 1, 1 or 2, more than 2. Answer is A, that is, there are 2 factors. Forfeiting provides finance against the export receivables to an exporter with recourse to the exporter without disclaiming the responsibility for non-payment of bill, without recourse to the exporter, both, either one. Answer is B, that is, both. Question comes next now. Forfeiture is an intermediary between an exporter and importer, an exporter, an importer, a bank. Forfeiture is an intermediary between an exporter and importer. So answer is choice A. Forfeiting provides to the exporter against receivables 100% financing, 80% financing, depending on the contract with the forfeiter, none. Answer is A, that is 100% of the receivable. Forfeiting enables the exporter to avoid the following risks: interest rate risk, currency risk, credit risk and political risk, all. Basically, it provides all the risks, and basically this provides mitigation of risk, one would can say. Bank guarantees are issued by any bank, only specified banks, only banks permitted to do this type of business, none. Answer is A, that by any bank. Next question, in a bank guarantee, the number of parties involved in the agreement are 3, 2, many, none. The answer is A, that is 3 parties. Letter of credit is defined in the Indian Contract Act, Negotiable Instrument Act, Transfer of Properties Act, none. Answer is D, letter of credit is not defined in any of these acts. A revolving letter of credit is one which provides that the amount of drawing stipulated in it will be available to the beneficiary. Choice A, again and again, as may be agreed between the buyer and the seller within the stipulated period. Choice B, any number of times. C, only once. D, none. Answer is A, that is, again and again, as may be agreed by the parties. Next question, a forward exchange contract is a firm contract for the purchase sale of specified quantity of a stated foreign currency at a predetermined exchange rate between the bank and its exporters, importers, both, none. The answer is C, exporters as well as importers. ECGC stands for Electronic Consumer Goods Corporation, option B, Export Consumer Goods Corporation, option C, Export Credit Guarantee Corporation, D, none of the above. Answer is C, ECGC stands for Export Credit Guarantee Corporation. UCPDC stands for Uniform Customs and Procedures for Direct Credits, Uniform Procedure for Documentary Credits, Uniform Customs for Practices for Documentary Credits, none of the above. Answer is B, that is, Uniform Procedures for Documentary Credits. The purchase of book debts or receivable is central to factoring, true or false? Answer is true. Again, true and false. The forfeiter doesn't take over burden of receivable collection. True or false? Answer is false. Factoring is beneficial to those clients who operate in seller's market. True or false? It is false. Forfeiting frees the export banker from debt collection. True or false? Answer is A, it's true. The purchase of book debts or receivable is central to factoring. True or false? Absolutely true. So option A. With this, we come to end of this session. In the next session, we'll cover bank's balance sheet.